Hello everyone, welcome back to Placement Buddies. Let me welcome you all to another video in this industrial instrumentation playlist. And today we are going to discuss about high pressure measurement devices, right? So in order to measure a pressure which is high, we can use three type of instruments: burden tube, which is again classified into C type burden tube and spiral type burden tube. We can use bellows and we can use diaphragms as well, right? So measurement of high pressure is also called measurement of pressure using elastic elements, as all these three elements which we are going to discuss in this video are elastic elements basically. So we will start with burden tube. The first category of burden tube is C-type burden tube. Okay, so as you can see in this diagram, in the C-type burden tube, one end called the tip of the tube is sealed and is called the free end, and the other end of the tube is fixed to a socket where the pressure to be measured is applied. This end, okay. So the first end is sealed and it is called the free end, and the next end, which is the other end of the tube, it is fixed to a socket where the pressure to be measured is applied. We are going to measure this pressure, right, which is very high. Now the internal pressure tends to change the section of the tube. This pressure will change the section of the tube. It will bend in a way, okay, it will bend in this way as shown in this arrow. The movement of the tube is ideally proportional to the pressure applied, right? Now as it will bend in this particular direction, this tip will also move along with it, right? So basically pressure is measured by you can say inferring it in terms of displacement. So as the displacement increases, the pressure also increases, and vice versa, right? So basically this is the mechanism of C-type burden tube. Next we will see what is a spiral type burden tube. So in spiral type burden tube, these tubes are made by winding several turns of the tube with its flattened cross section in the form of a spiral, as you can see clearly in this diagram, right? Now when the pressure to be measured is applied to the spiral, this is the pressure which I am talking about, right, it tends to uncoil, producing a relatively long movement of the tip. Now when you will apply pressure, yahan se jab aap प्रेशर अप्लाई करोगे, तब क्या होगा कि ये जो स्पाइरल है ये अनकॉइल हो जाएगा. जब ये अनकॉइल होगा तब जो डिस्प्लेसमेंट ये प्रोड्यूस करेगा, डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ द टिप, दैट विल बी मच लार्जर देन व्हाट वी हैव सीन इन सी टाइप बर्डन ट्यूब. सो यू कैन से काइंड ऑफ सेंसिटिविटी विल बी मोर इन केस ऑफ स्पाइरल टाइप बर्डन ट्यूब एज कंपेयर टू दैट ऑफ सी टाइप बर्डन ट्यूब, राइट. अगेन स्पाइरल टाइप बर्डन ट्यूब में वही है, डिस्प्लेसमेंट हम देखते हैं एंड वी मेजर द प्रेशर इन टर्म्स ऑफ डिस्प्लेसमेंट, राइट. नाउ वी विल सी व्हाट आर द मटेरियल्स यूज्ड फॉर बर्डन ट्यूब. द मटेरियल्स यूज्ड फॉर कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ बर्डन ट्यूब आर ब्रास, एलॉय स्टील, स्टेनलेस स्टील, ब्रोंज, फॉस्फोर ब्रोंज, बेरिलियम कॉपर एटसेट्रा, एंड द रेंज विच इट कवर्स इज 760 मिलीमीटर ऑफ मर्करी टू 700 मेगापास्कल, राइट. सो द नेक्स्ट एलिमेंट इज बेलोज. At first we will discuss what are the materials used for bellows. The materials used for bellows are brass, bronze, beryllium, copper, alloys of nickel and copper, steel and monel, etc. Now as you can see, this is the diagram of bellows. Bellows is basically a series of circular parts resembling the folds in an accordion as shown in this figure. As you can see, it is a series of circular parts resembling the folds in accordion, right. Now these parts are formed or joined in such a manner that they are expanded or contracted axially by change in pressure. यहां से प्रेशर आएगा, प्रेशर जितना चेंज होगा, ये जो बेलोज वाले पार्ट है इनका एक्सपांशन होगा, कंट्रैक्शन होगा उसी अकॉर्डिंग. चेंज ऑफ प्रेशर विल लीड टू द एक्सपांशन एंड कंट्रैक्शन ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर बेलोज एलिमेंट्स, राइट. ओके, सो द नेक्स्ट एलिमेंट विच वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इज डायफ्राम्स. सो एज यू कैन सी, दिस इज द डायग्राम ऑफ अ डायफ्राम. बेसिकली द प्रेशर टू बी मेजर्ड इज अप्लाइड टू द डायफ्राम, कॉजिंग इट टू डिफ्लेक्ट. This is the pressure P, right? Pressure apply करने के वजह से diaphragm deflect हो जाएगा. So basically before the application of pressure, the diaphragm used to be here in this along with this line, okay? ये straight line के बराबर diaphragm रहेगा. जब pressure apply होगा वो deflect होके नीचे ऐसे bend हो जाएगा, right? The maximum deflection DM, as you can see, this is the maximum deflection DM, and the deflection at any radius DR. This is the deflection at any radius dr, okay. So the ranges are basically 0 to 50 newton per meter square and 0 to 200 kilo newton per meter square. So this is basically the mechanism of a diaphragm. Diaphragm mein kya hota hai, प्रेशर अप्लाई करने के वजह से डिफ्लेक्शन प्रोड्यूस होता है, राइट? सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द डिवाइसेस यूज्ड फॉर मेजरिंग हाई प्रेशर, राइट? सो इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर लेवल मेजरमेंट्स. सो दैट्स इट फॉर टुडे गाइस. थैंक यू, हैव अ नाइस डे.